हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल। इट्स मी अर्पिता। सो वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल आफ्टर लॉन्ग लॉन्ग टाइम। सो इन माय टुडेज वीडियो आई हैव पिक्ड अप अ टॉपिक ऑप्टिकल फाइबर कम्युनिकेशन व्हिच इज़ वन ऑफ द सब्जेक्ट इन इलेक्ट्रॉनिक्स एंड कम्युनिकेशन डिपार्टमेंट। सो बिफोर गोइंग डीप इन टू वॉट इज़ ऑप्टिकल फाइबर कम्युनिकेशन, वॉट इट्स ब्लॉक डायग्राम, हाउ इट वर्क्स एंड ऑल, इट्स वेरी मच नेसेसरी फॉर अस टू see the history behind the developments that has happened in the area of communication. Yes. So the first topic in the optical fiber communication is historical development. So we are going to see what has been the history before the evolution of optical fiber in the communication sector. Okay, so we are going to see how it has evolved. Okay, so this optical fiber communication did not evolve all of a sudden. Okay, it went through years and years of improvements. Okay, so with years of development in all the components and the technology, this has evolved into the present optical fiber communication. Okay, so the application of its has reached to the vast area, and we are going to see how it was done. Okay, so this the history or the past of a optical fiber it takes us back to the 800 BC. okay, so what I mean to say is it's not just today's matter, it has started all in the early 800. Okay, so what happened in the early 800? So I'm going to put it first for you. Okay, so in early 800 BC, okay, what happened is Greeks first started using, Greeks used, what did they use? They use fire. Okay, fire and smoke, you must have seen in very old movies. Okay, they used to use these fires or even the smoke to signal or to communicate with the people. Okay, so it was used for sending information during wars. Okay, so you must have, if you have watched any old movies, you must have come across people taking the fire, like, you know, fire stick, or you can or smokes, using smokes to signal somebody or to communicate with someone. Okay, so with some information. Okay, so this is the first evolution of communication that happened way back in 800 BC and which was first started by the Greeks. Okay, so coming to the next thing, so it's started, like, in the sense it was there. Okay, until the next century, second century, this thing was carried out. So now when we reached around second century, okay, what happened in second century? Little improvements were happened. Okay, what happened is here there was a introduction of signaling device, which we also called as signaling lamps. Okay, so you can just surf and Google how they look, signaling lamps. Okay, if you just type in signaling lamps, you will get an idea. Even these you must have seen in the movies. Okay, so these signaling lamps acted as visual signaling devices. Okay, these acted as visual signaling devices for what? For communication. Now what kind of a communication? We are talking about optical communication. Why I'm using optical communication here, unlike the first point? Because here the communication is happening using the light. Okay, so signaling lamps, lamp is nothing but a source of light, right? So here some kind of a codes were used, which we call it as Morse code. Okay, so here in the history, that is in the second century, during second century, signaling lamps came into the existence, which were used as a main devices or visual signaling devices for optical communication. Here I am using optical communication because this is the point of time where we were using light, okay, source of light, as the medium to communicate, okay, using Morse code. So this Morse code for different they had codes for different information or different message. Okay, so this is what it says. Now next, coming to the third point, what happened again with the some more improvements? Okay, so later in 1880. Okay, so when we reached around 1880, we all know the Alexander Graham Bell. Okay, so whenever you talk about Alexander Graham Bell, yes, the one thing that strikes to you is telephone, right? Exactly. So later in 1880, Alexander Graham Bell, what he did, he came up with technology. Okay, what technology he came up, or he introduced, or he reported, you can say, okay, came up with the technology of speech, right? What did he introduce? He introduced telephone, we all know that. So he came up with the technology of transmission. Okay, so what transmission? Transmission of speech, because you use telephone to what? To speak to someone who is away from you or who is residing at the distance place, right? So this is first time in the history Alexander Graham Bell came up with the technology of transmission of speech, right? So though the communication is about speech here, but this was done with the help of light. Okay, so with the help of light beam, okay, which could travel over the distance. Okay, over the distance. So hence again, this was a form of optical communication, because here we are taking the help of a light to transmit our speech, or we are using the light beam to communicate, right? So this was the improvement in the optical fiber communication. So but what happened is, after this period we couldn't see much of the improvements. Why? There was no suitable light source which could overcome all the difficulties that we faced at that time due to optical fiber communication. It couldn't take forward. The optical fiber communication couldn't see any more developments due to some hurdles. Okay, so why? I'll just write down here. It was due to the main point was it was due to the lack of suitable light source. Okay, so you know that for any transmission of a communication, you need a source, you need a medium to transmit, and you need a receivers, right? So here, due to the lack of suitable light sources and even detectors, okay, even if you had a light source, but you need to have some devices, okay, or medium which can detect the information what you're sending, okay, so that should be suitable or perfect. Okay, so then, and some atmospheric disturbances were also seen, okay, which was not giving the optimal output, right? So hence these were the shortcomings. Okay, disturbances, how, what kind of a disturbances we are talking? The signal was not reached effectively from the source to the receiver due to the rain, or due to the fog, or due to the smoke, any environmental disturbances you can just name here, okay, etc. So what happened? So shortcomings, these limitations, what did it do? It limited further improvements. Okay, further improvements in, okay, due to these further improvements in optical fiber communication, I'm writing it in short, was limited. In the sense, it was not there was no proper improvements happening due to these shortcomings. Until you overcome these shortcomings, you cannot go forward with the technology, right? So hence this, the limitations of application of optical fiber was limited to only certain sector. Now where was it limited? It was limited to the application of only mobile communication. So optical fiber communication just got limited to the only mobile communication. It just saw a usage in the mobile, okay, mobile communications. So this was the main drawback, or we can say a setfall, or which took many years to see what we are seeing today, what improvements we are seeing today in the optical fiber communication. If there were no hurdles of what I mentioned in the point 4, then we could have seen the applications of optical fiber communication what we are seeing today in an early stage, like, okay. So now what happened? Now when, how did we move to the next generation, or you can say the improvements in the optical fiber communication? We will see with the introduction of what? You must have heard a laser, right? So I'll just tell you how did it come. Okay, so next point, what it is? So the next point is 5. I told you with the introduction or with the invention of a laser. So what is this laser? It's a light amplification of stimulated emission of radiation. You must have heard this all over your semesters, okay? So with the invention of laser technology, okay, so what happened? Who introduced this one? Who invented by Meumann in 1960? These are important to write because it's mentioned there to elaborate about a historical development of OFC, right? So hence this is at some point it becomes very important that you just mention these statistics so that it adds value to your answer. So now after the invention of laser technology, optical fiber communication became the future, okay, the future of communication, okay, the future of communication as, okay, as how? Because laser technology is a powerful. Why did it became future of communication? Because they started with the use of laser technology, they started seeing the future of communication. They started seeing the improvements that could be made into the in the field of a communication. So hence that saw some positive signs, okay, with the invention of laser technology. There was a big sign or big improvement sign of a optical fiber communication, okay. So because laser is a powerful light source, okay, it's a powerful light source. In the beginning itself I told you, due to the lack of suitable light source, we couldn't see much of the improvements. So hence with the invention of laser, okay, they could see a future of communication. So since it's a powerful, you can write it as coherent light source, okay, since it's a powerful coherent light source, okay, and it is suitable optical carrier, okay, since it's a powerful light source and hence it is a optical light carrier, okay. So it has to carry the medium, like it has to be transmitted. So with the invention of laser, there was a new ray of hopes in the technology of optical fiber. Then what happened? Then many scientists proposed in the sense they came up with a proposal, okay. What proposal? They proposed transmission, okay, of optical signals, okay. So they proposed the transmission of optical signals through optical dielectric waveguides. So this is what we call communication of optical fiber, okay. So the transmission of optical or the transmission of a light, okay, or the transmission of a message through the light signals, okay, through what? Through some medium. You need to transmit through medium, right? Through optical dielectric waveguide. It's nothing but a optical fiber communication. So many scientists propose transmission of optical signals through optical dielectric waveguide, okay. But what happened? But these waveguides had some problem. What problem? But these waveguides exhibited some kind of a waveguides exhibited in the sense they showed, okay, what? Very high attenuation, in the sense loss, okay, very high attenuation. So whenever you transmit any information to reach it to the receiver, it should have been carried without any disturbances through the all through the medium. So if it undergoes any loss in between, so you will not receive the signal effectively. So this is what happened. The transmission of optical signal through dielectric waveguides exhibited a kind of attenuation, a kind of loss there. Information loss was there, and it was around 1000 decibel per kilometer, okay. And if it was transmitted through a coaxial cable, what would be the attenuation? It would be of coaxial cable, it was around 10 decibel per kilometer, right? So what happened? And there should, we knew that there was a loss of information and there was attenuation, very high attenuation, which has to be overcome. So then what happened with the improvements, certain improvements were made, and in a decade, in the sense in a 10-year period, okay, after this problem, see, the optical fiber saw some improvements, okay, the optical fiber loss was reduced. So this attenuation problem was reduced to how much? Reduced to less than, okay, less than 5 decibel per kilometer. Okay, I hope this is clear to you. Okay, so let's move on again to the next. What happened? What are the next improvements made in the optical fiber? So next we have moved to the 1970s. Okay, let me write down in 1970s, or you can say during 1970 to 80s. We have reached to our 80s now. So you must have read even in other subjects, like, okay, about semiconductors. So here, advancement or introduction of semiconductors, okay, advancements made in semiconductor technology, okay. So advancements in semiconductor technology brought many changes into the field of optical fibers, okay, optical fiber. So what happened here exactly? Advance in semiconductor technology, you know, increase the laser from 1000 hours to 7000 hours, okay, increase the laser from 1000 hours to 7000 hours, okay, the duration was increased. And here these semiconductor optical sources, you must have seen what the limitations we face due to the sources, okay. So now when the sources were made using semiconductor technology, so semiconductor optical sources and detectors, okay, what were made with the implementation of a semiconductor technology, that were compatible in size, okay, they were of appropriate size that could be used as a source and detectors, okay, they were compatible. Please be careful with that. It's compatible, okay, let me change it. Okay, so it's compatible, they were compatible with the size, compatible with size compatibles in size with optical fiber okay compatible in size. So hence here optical, whatever optical fibers were designed and fabricated, they were good, okay, they were suitable for the detectors and you can say sources, light sources. So this was the improvement made, or improvements happened due to the advancement in the semiconductor technology. Then when we moved to a later in 1980s, okay, 1980s, when we reach 1980s, what happened? Optical systems operated now almost much of the improvements were made. So here optical systems operated at what period, what speed? That is Mbps, okay. Then, but you know that today's system operated what speed? We are into terabyte, right? Yes. So today's systems operate at 10 gigabytes per second and even beyond. Yes or not? Yes. So advancement in technology and introduction, why, how did, was it possible, like how the speed increase, why are we seeing so much changes, drastic changes over the period of time in the communication field due to the usage of optical fiber communication, is because there were lots of advancement were made in the technology and there were new things introduced. So some of their to name was DWDM, okay, and you can call EDFA. With the advancement in technology and with the introduction of these new technology, the data rate, okay, went beyond from gigabytes to terabytes per second, okay, and it was traveling over a distance of kilometers, which was in meters. You must have seen here, I had mentioned here the communication started, okay, here with the help of light beam over the distances, and this distances was just in meters. We were talking about in meters. Now here with the invention or with the advancement in the technology, with the introduction of the new technologies, the transmission of light was carried out to the kilometers. Okay, so what is this DWDM? So I'm not going very depth into it. DWDM is, one is dense wavelength. So this you can you'll read it in future, so don't worry much about it. So this is new technology. So right now let us concentrate on what the present thing what we are looking at. Okay, so multiplexers, and this one is called as erbium doped fiber amplifier. Okay, yes. So due to these, okay, introduction of these new technologies or advancement in this technology, data rates, okay, go beyond terabytes, in the sense the transmission of data, okay, the transmission of information, the speed got increased per second over drastically, okay, and over distances which were in spoken in kilometers, okay, which was this is in excess of 100 kilometers. Okay, so these were the advancements which were made in the optical fiber system, and this is how the improvements over the period of years, the optical fiber has seen changes. So this are the points, few of the points which you can write for your historical development, that the optical fiber communication has seen for years and years, and now from the past to the present where we see. You can just write down, put in these 8 points. I think all your work will be done. So I hope I'll just get back to you with the next topic in very soon in my next videos. Till then, keep studying. So take care, stay home, stay safe, and this is my message to contain the COVID-19. So I take up a chance to request you to stay home and stay safe. So keep studying. So meet you in the next video. Okay, bye bye.